going to determine the excess pressure in drops and bubbles. First, we take to find the excess pressure in a liquid drop. Suppose this is the liquid drop. Every liquid drop is in a spherical shape due to the surface tension. Due to the surface tension, we know that every liquid drop tries to attain the minimum surface area. Here, surface area is minimum for only spherical shape. We having different shapes like cylinder, cone, various shapes are there. Among the various shapes for a given volume, the surface area is only for spheres. That is the reason why every liquid drop is in the spherical shape. Now, liquid drop is retaining in the spherical shape, nothing bad. The pressure inside the liquid drop is excess than the pressure acting on it in all directions. Now, this is a liquid drop. Inside the liquid drop, the suppose pressure is Pi, and all over which the atmospheric pressure is Pi is acting, it is retaining in the same size, means the pressure inside the liquid drop is greater than the atmospheric pressure is acting on it, so that the excess pressure inside the liquid drop is P excess is equal to Pi minus P naught. It is derived like this here. Suppose we consider the upper half of the liquid drop. This upper half of the liquid drop is being pulled down by the lower half, and also lower half is being pulled up by the upper half. Now, the upper half is being pulled down with how much force? With a force T into 2 pi r. How do you get this now here? Now, according to surface tension formula, surface tension is equals to force by length. The downward force suppose is F, and it is acting along the length circumference of the drop. That is 2 pi r. Here we suppose the r is the radius of the drop, and also the force due to excess pressure acting on it in upward direction is, inside it excess pressure is P excess. Now it is acting on the area A. Now this area of the liquid drop is A, so P excess into A, it is acting in upward direction. Now in an equilibrium position, the upward force is equal to the downward force. The upward force is P excess into A, and downward force is T into 2 pi r. Now T into 2 pi r is equal to P excess into the area on which excess pressure is acting is, that is A nothing but area of this circle, that is pi r square. Here pi is cancelled, R is cancelled, so 2T is equal to P excess into R, P excess is equals to 2T by R. Now P excess is equal to 2T by R is the formula for excess pressure in a liquid drop. P excess can also be written as Pi minus P naught is equal to 2T by R, Pi is equal to P naught plus 2T by R.